It's Beer O'Clock on Real Ale Craft Beer, and today is a really, really exciting day for me on the channel. I invested in the blade. I crossed my fingers because when I ordered the blade, when I invested my own hard-earned money for this blade, there was only two beers out in the UK. Beer Amaretti and Heineken. I went with a gut feeling that there was going to be more beers going to be released for this system, and was I right? We've got Afligem Blonde, there's a lager that's just come out, and this is why I'm really excited. One of my favorite, if not favorite, styles of beer is Weissbier. I now have 8 liters of Weissbier to get through on my blade, and it's 5.3% ABV. We're going to do an open, honest, unbiased review. I'm going to be honest with you as to what I think about this beer. So let's show you how to load it up first. So tap, take that off on the end, get rid of that. And then what you do, I'm going to try and do it here for you, is that you push this little button in, this little orange button, be firm with it, like that. Okay, so what you do is you take the dome off first on the blade system. This can be a little bit tricky with the keg, because it is an 8-litre keg and it does weigh a little bit. So pull the nozzle, or pull the tap forward, as so. You're only, as I mentioned earlier, you're only touching the orange parts of the machine and the keg. So, little orange button there to push. You grab hold of the keg, and this is what I've learned to do, is you grab the line and put the line in between your fingers like that. And then you load it down like so. The line goes down into there. And then we're in. Right, there you should hear a clunk. So we are in. Simply put the top back on here. What have I done here now? There you go, get rid of that there. So that goes back there. I'm just gonna grab the camera. And then from the front, turn the machine on the side here. And then you lock it down. Okay, so I've just pulled one off here just to save a bit of time. So let's get the second one out. Okay, so here is the Weissbier. Looks incredible. Fantastic looking beer, hazy, wheaty looking beer. I've been messing about with the video, so I've had to set back up the tripod. So it did have a 2-finger white head. It's got a 1-finger white head now. I've added a little bit more beer as well to it, because the head dissipated a bit as I was setting the tripod back up, so I put a bit more beer in. Hence the, I mean, normally you'd have a bigger head on a Weissbier. I feel like I'm not doing it the right justice, but it's all down to the flavour. You can see the carbonation, hazy amber colour. Let's get the aroma. And that is just the most banana-y, clovey, lovely. It's wheaty, biscuity, banana, clove, spice. It smells tremendous. Let's dive in. Cheers. Fantastic temperature. A fantastic taste. Banana, clove, spices, Stone the Crow. Stone the Crow's what a great beer. And the biggest thing, I got 8 litres of it. I got 8 litres of this for pure enjoyment. Carbonation, nice, rising up nicely up the side of the glass. Great temperature again. Great smoothness of the beer. Carbonation pushes the beer on the inside of the mouth. Banana, clove, spice, wheat. Here we go, let's knock this head up a bit. I must admit though, you know, in all honesty, for a Weissbier, it is struggling a little bit with its head. I'm really washing this round now and... No, you know, normally it would just spring back up a little bit more than it has done. Maybe it's just the particular style they brew the Edelweiss Hefetru Weizenbier in. I've had the Edelweiss Hefetru on the Krups. It was really good. Now I'm drinking it on the Blade. I'm just really pleased I got 8 litres of it. It's one of my favourite styles of beer of all time, as I mentioned earlier, if not my favourite style. And this is a really good one. The banana, the clove, I would say more banana over the clove, but I reckon the banana flavour on this is really ripe. It's like really ripe banana. Fabulous. Right, let's get this down a little bit more so that we can really kind of shake up this glass and see if we can recreate a bit of a hedger. Right, here we go. Ah, here we go. It's better. Yeah, it's much better. Okay, I think I'm ready to rate it. Out of the Blade, beautiful temperature, lovely and cold, fantastic flavours. Really enjoying it. I'm gonna rate it. I like that enough. See, now I compare everything to Pearl and Backer Patronus. It's like Perlenbacher Patronus in Lidl, 500ml bottle, always in stock, always there. So it's like my go-to Weissbier. Franciscaner Weissbier used to be my go-to Weissbier. And then the price started going up with Franciscaner, so I kind of moved away a little bit from Franciscaner, because I always remembered Franciscaner to be £1. And I moved over to the Perlenbacher Patronus because it's £1.25 a bottle. It's a fantastic price for what you get for the beer. And it's whenever I review a Weissbier, I always mark it up in my head. Is it as good as Perlenbacher Patronus? This is better. This is better. I'm a little bit disappointed with the carbonation. I must admit, I'm a little bit disappointed with the carbonation. But this is a much, much flavoursome, much more flavoursome beer than the Patronus. You get much more of a banana vibe going on, much more clove. It's almost like Perlenbacher Patronus on steroids, this, it really is. So the Edelweiss Hefetru Weizenbier, I believe they're from Austria. They're an Austrian company. I like it enough to give it... Do you know, I would have given it full marks if it wasn't for the head. It doesn't have too much lacing on the glass, and the head's a little bit disappointing. But that's just appearance. That is just appearance. But for a Weiss beer, for some, that does matter. So I like this beer enough to give it... I'm going to take one mark away. I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10. I'm taking one mark away for the just the head, just the appearance. But I like it enough to give it a 9 out of 10. So 9 out of 10 from Real Ale Craft Beer. Please put your comments in the comments box. Subscribe to our daily beer and food reviews. Give us a big fat thumbs up. Boom! Cheers.